You've all had your ideas. They have all failed. I am king. Not you! Not you! Not you! Me!
bWo, we are here. It is Friday. Man, I'm feeling good. It's been a long week, and actually, I'm lying. See, it has not been a good time. See, as commissioner, since I've taken over this division, we've had some bumps in the road, and there was one goal I had in mind. That one goal was to better the division, to take superstars who are brand new and give them the rightful time they deserve and push others to the top and have this place explode. And a few people helped me along the way. And one person that should have done that was DB. Now, DB, great as he is, great champion, great competitor, he was there day one. For those of you who don't know, we've been in multiple groups together. This is our second promo group, and it has been just thick and thin, you would think. But no, ever since he got a little bit more than he could chew, he took over the hosting one time, and I don't know what happened, but something happened, something clicked, that he thought he was greater than the sum of this division's parts, and that led to DB greatness, DB champion, DB airhead, if you will. Because I thought I had a friend. And little did I know I had someone who was waiting to strip the rug from right under me and have me fall on my ass. When we have no shows, when we have people that underdeliver and then place the blame on me, that's not a friend, DB. So, over the last couple of weeks, you seem to have lost your way. First, you have this, I don't even know what to call it. You have this overcompensation, and then you win the Talk Your Shit Championship. Congratulations, by the way. But this has gotten out of hand. This is too far. You see, DB, you may have taken over the hosting. You may have won over the people. But you're not fooling anyone. You're not fooling me anymore. So it's time. It's beyond time for me to take everything back. I've started with the hosting. I'm starting again by taking this division back. Hell. I'm taking my screen time back. Y'all want to know why I haven't seen DB recently? It's because DB is in Facebook jail. And the reason he was in Facebook jail is because of me. That's not going to stop there. No, I won't stop until I put you back in the dirt. I am going to now take your TYS championship. That's right. You can't keep my name out of your mouth so much that I'm going to give you one more opportunity to actually put it in context. So Bloodbath, June 18th, it's going to be you and me for the Talk Your Shit championship. You're welcome. Excuse me. Anyway, we had a packed show so far tonight, and one of those things is a new outlook from the human cheat code Bones. And last we checked in, he started his rehab. So it is week two. Let's see how he's doing.
One week down, y'all. One week. No alcohol. It's been hard. I've been tempted. It's like I've been walking in the wilderness this whole time. But this week's been hard, but I've resisted temptation. And at this point in my journey, this point in our journey, because we're going on this journey together as I documented for you guys. At this point in my journey, I need to admit that if anybody knows me, you would know, you would say that I'm agnostic. I've had a lot of questions. I've been very disrespectful to certain people. I apologize for people because I've realized that that's part of why my life went to a tailspin. I have to accept that there is a God above me, and that God is the only one who can restore me to my former self and like make me sane and whole again. So, Father, if you're listening, I'm here. Let's keep taking these steps together.
Amen, brother. Amen. Now, me, if we're being honest, between you and me, Bones, I've been praying for you, man. I am a firm believer that anybody can change. Anybody can change. So you are on the right path. So I'm excited for what's in store, but what is in store next is our opening matchup for this week. The one and only workhorse, the true workhorse, the bWo, that is Apollo Armstrong, has something on his chest that he's got to get off from them kids against the Mad King, who we haven't really seen since Promo Mania. So Mad King Apollo. Who is it gonna be? Let's see it.
Get to me, it worked. I'm on tip. I tell my neighbor, let me holler at you real quick. I say, I got a band, tell me who hit the lick. A good spin move, I ain't gonna get this nigga sick. He like, that's a bit, but I only know where one at. He in cell 30, go there, you might not come back. This the number where I need you to send that one stack. 313, I walked away on this dumbass. I'm about to cut the yard up. But your niggas doing dirty. Whoever in cell 30 getting carved up. I'm feeling like I went dead. Let me charge up. Still doing drills.
Yeah. It's your boy, Apollo, your unified, undisputed, fuck them kids because they got me fucked up champion, the master of mess, the promo deviant, and yes, I have adopted another moniker, Mr. No Days Off. And here I have with me my bloodline. Young man, hey Junior, tell me a joke.
Mad King.
Okay, whoever tell the best joke wins. Hey, AJ, tell me a joke.
Era of Reality.
I guess nobody won that because they both fucking jokes. Let me tell you something. The Era of Reality, y'all are the four pillars. But here's the thing about a pillar. While strong and having the ability to hold up a foundation, one pillar can't do it on its own. So I'm going to take you guys out one by one, starting with the Angry Prince. The deranged bishop, the sad jester, whatever you want to call yourself. Well, you better get your game face on, because Apollo came to play. Fortunately, I had to do a cutaway, which may cost me points. But, you know, I was outside with those mosquitoes, and those mosquitoes, just like the Mad King, fucking suck. Literally. And I mean that literally for the mosquitoes in the Mad King. But listen up here, Mad King. You tell a good story like Stephen King. You talk a good talk like Don King. But you're about to get your ass whooped like Rodney King. The time of kings has come and gone. So do yourself a favor and take your royal scepter and whoop your own ass just to save you the embarrassment. I'm coming for the Era of Reality. And the first step on my homicide of the Era of Reality, it's regicide. Long live.
Live the king.
You too harshly.
bWo, it's been a minute. You know, Talking Shit Championship didn't go our way. Promo Mania didn't go our way. But now we're up here against Apollo Armstrong. Is that his name? Apollo Armstrong? I can't even remember. Because I don't remember the names of people who don't want to be cool. I mean, Apollo Anderson's entire gimmick is being the lovable loser. It's like, when I lose, it's a surprise. When Apollo loses, that's expected. And I feel like the insult here is that the powers that be feel like I need this in order to get back on track. And the problem with that for me is that it's fucking insulting. It's fucking insulting that you put me up against this piece of promo trash. This guy who is beneath me. This guy who on his best day can't hang with me on my worst day. It's like, yeah, Apollo has been growing in confidence. He's been growing in experience. But oh my God, this level 3 bitch can't hang with a god. Apollo is going to sit back in his car, or he's going to sit in his apartment in front of a plate of food. And the thing about it is, it doesn't matter what he says, because what you feel from him is his sad, unproductive, lonely existence. You feel that when you talk, or when he talks. You feel depressed listening to an Apollo Armstrong promo, because Apollo Armstrong is depressing. Apollo Armstrong doesn't bring joy. He has to sit any place that he goes becomes darker. Whereas you see me, I'm sitting out here in the world, and the world is bright. And yet I am forced to climb myself up by stepping over this dead carcass of what should be a promising promo guy. And I feel shame. I feel shame that this is where I'm at. I feel shame that this is where you think that I'm at. I feel shame because I am better than Apollo Armstrong. I always have been. I've already beaten Apollo Armstrong. And you guys think that, what, he's going to somehow miraculously get better at this? That somehow he's going to be able to contend with me? This guy is pure trash. He's had opportunity after opportunity after opportunity. And he's done exactly what you guys expected him to do, because no one here has expected Apollo Armstrong to win. Apollo Armstrong isn't the guy who wins. He's the guy who bends over so you can step on his back to climb to the top. Apollo Armstrong is a waste of promo space. And he's not good enough to hang with me on this PDL or any other.
What a contest. Every time I see Apollo, I think about them kids. And he just takes it to another level each and every time. But the Mad King actually came to play. This is the Mad King that we've all wanted to see from day one. He took out Hez, DB, Mitch. That Mad King is back. Thank you for coming back. And as you all have seen the last few weeks, Trevor, the promo artist, the best, the king of the bWo, trademark copyright officially, he's inserted himself into the Bloodbath Championship match. And that is actually what's best for business. So, ladies and gentlemen, officially today, next Saturday, will be a triple threat match for the promo championship. It's going to be the HNIC, the promo devil, taking on AT, the power player, and also Trevor Robinson. Now, I've already heard from one of the three competitors, so why not hear from the other two? So HNIC and AT have got something to say. Let's see what it is.
Well, well, well. Look what the cat dragged in. Yes, people, it is me, the power player, A motherfucking T. Now, I know what you're thinking, You're like, where the hell have you been? Well, let me tell you where I've been. I needed to take a break from the BW. I feel like they've been working me like a fucking dog for the last few weeks and not paying me my worth. But see, that's a different conversation. But as you can see, I look good, I smell good, I am good, because I've been traveling the world, wine and dining the finest women this world can offer, because that's what I do. But the thing is, I really need to take a break. I need to take a break for myself, because I must admit something. Damn. The thing is, I did not give my best the last time you saw me, people. The last time you saw me at the pay-per-view, the last pay-per-view, I lost the King of the Mic tournament. And I lost to none other than Trevor. Boring ass, white ass Trevor. And the truth is, I know for a fact that my presence in our match made him really step the fuck up. But I also must admit that I didn't give my best and I dropped the fucking ball. I was on a winning streak. And I was trying to continue to go on my winning streak, but I let myself down. And if I let myself down, that means that I also let you people down. And see, that is not what I do. But that is the past. And now it's the present. And then it will be the future. And the future is me. The future is mine. The future is AT, the power player, who is also the bWo champion. That sounds so amazing. And I had my match, something that I've been waiting for a long, long time, against the head nigga in charge, Lamar. The bWo champion for now. But then something else happened. Something else happened. That motherfucking boring ass, white ass Trev had to rain on my parade again. But see, unlike last time, this outcome will be different. So you're cashing in, well, I'm cashing out as the bWo champion. So Lamar, who I already beat, and you, Trav, watch your asses, because I'm coming for you. Because I am AT the power player, and that's what the fuck I do.
Trevor, you want this?
Oh, yeah. It ain't over, motherfucker.
AT, you want this? Well, y'all two come get it. I'll make it simple for you, bWo. Give me both of them. Because the way I'm seeing shit, I gotta remind y'all, all of y'all, bWo, exactly who the hell I am and why I carry this and why I am the champ. Because you motherfuckers must have forgot. It's alright. Come bloodbath. I'm gonna remind y'all exactly who the fuck I am and why I'm the champ. See you two hoes at bloodbath.
Oh, I can't wait for next week. I think y'all can wait. I can't wait. June 18th, bloodbath. It's going to be, as one former WWE commentator said, slobber knocker. Three competitors. I think it's the first time ever that we've had a triple threat competition. We've had a fatal four-way, but a triple threat for the main promo championship. I'm excited. There's so much at stake. We've got records and we've got a championship and we've got glory all on the line. It's like nothing makes me smile more than hungry competitors. Speaking of hungry competitors, we've got one of two in our main event tonight. But before I talk about that, we gotta talk about merch. Not this one, because I'm actually leaving tomorrow to work with the E. Thank you, Rel, again. Rel, Henry, Mandish, for getting me in. Get me in the loop. But enough about me. Let's talk about the T. So we've got bwoshop.bigcartel.com. You can get all your lovely things. You've got the bucket hats, the hoodies, the tank tops, the short shorts, the booty shorts that someone's been requesting. I don't know why. It's kind of, you know, it's out there. But our ladies, if y'all are into that stuff. And of course, you have the iconic button and tuck. You've got the polo of the BWO promo division. And you can get that, get it shipped within a week. Week's time. I know it's not Amazon fast, but it's fast. You're going to enjoy it. You're going to love it. Promise. All that's great. You've got so many options, so many customizations, and it's going to be free shipping. F-R-E-E, that spells free, creditreport.com, baby. Don't quote me on that. It's probably really cheap shipping, though. $5 at the most, maybe $8 if you live in California. Apologize. Y'all got it rough right now. As a Floridian, y'all got it rough right now. But without further ado, your main event, we've got a different breed vagabond settling an old score that keeps popping up in the locker room. I don't know. You can't put this guy down. He's not even the old yeller. I don't know what to call him of the group. He's the fire starter, the instigator, MC Gas. You all know him. Well, the gas era continues to fuel itself. And will it be on the rise again against a different breed in vagabond? What a main event. Let's see it.
After all this time, now you choose to battle me. When you was 0-3 and I called you out and you was the BWO's newest whipping boy, like a white girl in a gang full of niggas getting tossed around left and right, you wanted no parts of me. You didn't want to battle me. But now you got a few wins, you got a tag title, now you choose to accept. Thomas, you a joke. You let these boys hype your head up, these quote-unquote demons, got you thinking you surpassed me? Have you ever won a world title? Have you ever had a world title match? Have you ever had the best match on the show? Have you ever beat anyone top tier? No. Stop letting these boys hype you up, thinking you're better than me. You ain't done shit I did. You won't continue to do shit that I do. I'm the best ever. I shock the world time in and time out. There's nothing you can do to surpass me. I could lose for years, and you still won't be better than me. Gas.
By show of hands, who actually cares about MC Gas being back in BWO?
Oh, hell no.
What about you? No?
Actually, I sneezed.
No? Hey, whoo, I see a hand. Oh, wait, you're just stretching. Okay.
Nobody cares about Gas, bro.
Okay. By show of hands, who cares about the Gas era?
Bro, that girl was trash.
Anybody? Yes? No? What about you?
Mid as fuck.
No. I see a hand. Oh, wait, you're stretching again. Right. Now that we got that out of the way, now that we've established things, everybody remembers MC Gas, right? Right? Ooh, I see a bunch of hands. Yeah, we all remember Gas, you know. The guy who's ducked me before. The guy who gets a little bit of alcohol in his system.
He gon' cry in the car again, watch.
Gets a little tipsy, sits in his car, puts on the camera, and gets absolutely emotional. That's the Gas I remember. And now he thinks he's gonna beat someone like me, the Vagabond, a whole different breed. What is he gonna do? Oh, I know, he's gonna bring up how I was losing before. Oh yes, I was losing before. But times have changed. I have surpassed and grown far beyond that of which of what I used to be since day one. And you, MC Gas, you've regressed.
Sad.
Because you want to put this idea out to the world that you're back, that you suddenly care, that you're motivated, when in reality you're not. You're trying to chase the old glory days that you never, ever had.
All you are is left.
Because you want to be champion again. You want to be remembered again. You want to tell the world who the fuck you are. But here's the problem with that gas.
These are just dreams and fantasies.
That's it.
They will never come into reality.
But here's a
reality that you're going to be
sick
to hear.
The reality of
which
that you don't stand a
chance against me.
Not even
a little bit. For all this
shit talk you
do,
everything you
say
is made. Everything
you do
is made. Every word that
comes out of your
lips. Get the fuck
out of my face. Get the fuck out of
the division. I don't want to see you
here because
you're gonna be
0-3.
And
guess what?
You're
0-3.
Vagabond, I am sorry that you lost DB, because man, you've got that fire. You've got it in you. We want to see more and more and more. Gas, I do want to see him more, but I don't know if you've got what it takes anymore. I don't know if you've got what's left, anything left in the tank, and I want to see more. We all want to see more. Now, I heard from a little bee down the street that there is a gas report on the way, so don't delay. Set your clocks. We've got so much coming up. We've got Bloodbath next weekend. You can see the list right over hither. We've got it coming up, and it's going to be one for the ages, followed by Stars and Stripes featuring a, you know, record-setting score against someone who isn't available right now. But all that and more you can find out on our YouTube page, on our Facebook page. Make sure you like, share, comment. Take a look at this gorgeous beard that is full and not scraggly like your old host DB Fluke Pants. Oh, find something that works out. I don't care anymore. The hashtags, hate them. Only hashtags I like are PDL, bWo, and King Sing. I mean, it's not there anymore. Punjabi Poppy. Keep that rolling. Without further ado, it's going to do it for this week's edition of PDL. It is me, your commissioner, Mike Tuck, CM Tuck. Don't forget it. You can follow that on socials if you want. You can even follow it on YouTube. I play drums a little bit, so it's a little spicy thing for those of you. But more than that, follow us on Facebook and YouTube, and even Instagram. We've got an Instagram page, so hit up Mr. bWo Sketch Lucas for that. Get involved, get some free merch. When we get to 500 followers, we go and give out some free merch. Without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, that'll do it. We'll see you on
greatness.
Smell that? Smells like bitch. Tuck, this sad farce that you call a career will be ending at Bloodbath. After I whoop your ass, leave me alone once and for all.
I am the very best.
In the greatest reign, for the Talk Your Shit Championship will continue. Oh, and for old time's sake, have a wonderful night.